Hey everyone, my name is Caroline Shin. I'm the Product Marketing Manager within the Microsoft 365 team, and I'm responsible for eDiscovery and audit capabilities. I'm joined here today by my colleague Iram Ares, and Iram is the Principal PM Manager for our eDiscovery capabilities within Microsoft 365. And together, we're super excited to be here today on behalf of our team to talk about the exciting new capabilities that we're providing to our customers to help them efficiently respond to their legal, regulatory, and internal obligations. So with that, let's get started. Just to give you a quick overview of what you can expect in the next 15 minutes, I'll first provide some background on the key challenges that we frequently hear from our customers that influence the products that we're building and providing to our customers today. Next, Iram will actually go a bit deeper into those new capabilities that are available and then help you understand how we can actually help solve some of those problems. And then lastly, we'll talk about what's next and what we're building next, and then provide some resources for you to get started. So with that, let's talk about what we're seeing in market and how that's helped us or inform us on what we're building today. So we often hear that digital data is growing exponentially, and it's making it very difficult and challenging for our customers to conduct e-discovery. So for instance, the more data that there is, the harder it is to find what you actually need. And on top of that, the recent shift towards remote work has accelerated our customers' digital transformation, and we've seen significant increase in Teams usage. In fact, just recently in April, we've seen over 200 million users participating in Teams meeting in a single day. However, as more users collaborate in chat-based workspaces such as Teams, which is much more dynamic, ephemeral, and informal, the traditional e-discovery solutions and methods that our customers are using aren't designed to discover this new type of content, such as reviewing full conversations with context or even including linked cloud attachments to the original message. So this is increasing the risk and complexity for teams responsible for responding to legal, regulatory, and internal obligations. In fact, according to a recent Gartner study, 68% expressed that they're struggling to manage their workloads as legal departments have been disrupted with the recent pandemic and the related economic effects related to that. So being able to quickly and effectively respond to the request in time is challenging, especially considering that unexpected and unplanned work are increasing for our legal teams. And on top of that, the traditional way of exporting large volumes of data is just adding more complexity, risk, and inefficiencies to discover that data, which is impacting business outcomes and the ability to respond to these requests with agility. And finally, as mentioned earlier, these new types of data is throwing a wrench in the current processes, impacting the time that it takes, and as a result, the cost of producing relevant data. In advanced eDiscovery, we collect the data at the source so you can discover that data where it lives and within the security and compliance boundary. In April of last year, we made significant enhancements and updates, which includes a more end-to-end workflow within Microsoft 365. And lastly, where customers see the greatest return on investment is the effective calling. Advanced eDiscovery intelligently calls and reduces that data using in-place machine learning and analytics capabilities. And to further help organizations respond to these requests to support your digital transformations and the challenges that you face today, we're excited to share several new capabilities, which Iram will actually walk you through in the next few minutes. So with that, I'll pass it over to Ram to walk you through these capabilities.
Thanks, Caroline. So again, my name is Iram Arras. I'm a principal PM here at Microsoft, and our team builds the discover and respond solutions, but we're going to focus specifically on advanced eDiscovery today. And to get started, we thought it'd be good to kind of just frame the conversation, just kind of explain what the thought was, what the principles were when we were building these features. And one thing that we do often, and it's the generosity of our customers, is we get a lot of feedback from customers. Customers share, these are the challenges that they're faced with right now. These are the issues that they're running into. And with COVID, you know, it's a pretty common feedback is that everybody's kind of impacted financially. And so things like taking a look at efficiency and risk and cost all of a sudden is significantly more important. So we took this feedback and we're going to show you how we want to contribute to these issues, contribute to these goals. And the way we broke it down is by kind of attacking a time aspect, right? See if we can make things more efficient, reducing the risk, which usually risk will inevitably turn into cost. We've heard stories of customers having to do with things like sanctions and things that are very, very expensive. And then just, again, the overall cost of running eDiscovery, it can be an expensive process. So there are opportunities for us to kind of look at specific pieces where we can improve that bottom line. So from a time perspective, the approach we want to take here is we have work that we've done for modern attachments. And if you've done eDiscovery with workloads such as like Teams or Exchange, if there's content that's being shared and it's being done through a link, you know, going to find and collect that content can be a very laborsome process. It could take a long time to do that. And so we're going to talk a little bit about modern attachments and how we might be able to help reduce the time with that feature. From a risk perspective, you know, we want to talk a little bit about how the API can contribute here. There are parts of the process that are pretty repetitive, and as opposed to having a human do that, and where it might be error prone with people doing that process, you can automate that and just let the system do this repeatable, defensible process. And then from a cost perspective, I want to talk a little bit about the collections work that we've been doing. There is a huge opportunity for us to really kind of optimize not just the flow, but really kind of help our customers reduce the amount of content that they are collecting, right, to reduce that over collection and also reduce the over preservation. So we're going to double click on modern attachments. And the goals here were we wanted to make it simple to collect the content. Right? So it should feel almost automatic when you're collecting anything. And if there are linked messages in there, if there are messages that contain link to content, we'll collect that content automatically for you by checking a box. From a review perspective, we wanted it to feel familiar. Like there is a nice mature process to be able to review the regular attachments. And we wanted to apply that same model to modern attachments so that there's kind of a low training effort to get started. And then from an export perspective, if there are downstream processes after advanced eDiscovery, we wanted to preserve these relationships, right? When there's a message that has a link to a document, we want to be able to preserve the fact that these two are related, and we'll put that in the load file for any downstream process. So let's get into a little more detail on how we do this. What is it that gets us to this point? And what we're going to do first is we're going to show a comparison, right, of what the current state is against what it is with the new advanced features. So in the current state, when we talk to customers about, well, how do you approach modern attachments today? What is the process that you take? And they walk us through it, and it's they run a search. Then after they run the search, they export the results of the search. And then they'll run a script against these exports. And what the script is doing, it's going to start looking for any messages that contain links, right, that might contain modern attachments. And these scripts will also look to see if that content has already been collected. And if it hasn't, then usually these scripts will turn all of this into a report. And so the report's going to show you these are all of the documents that are linked, but they were not collected. Now, some of our customers get a little more creative and they try to automate this next process, but there are some challenges there with those URLs. So for the most part, we're hearing that most customers are doing this manually. And then once they retrieve this content manually, then they have to be able to merge all of these exports and the load files, which could be, you know, a nice long process. Now, for advanced eDiscovery with modern attachments, the flow is now when you run any collection, anytime you're going to collect content, there's going to be a checkbox. So there's a checkbox where you say, I want to also include anything that might be linked, any modern content, modern attached content. And when you check that and you run the collection, this content's automatically placed into the case. And once it's in the case, we'll show you that relationship. And I'm going to click here so there's going to zoom into a panel. There's a panel that's going to say any message that has any linked content will appear in this panel, right? So you'll be able to see all of the other content that's related to the message that you're looking at. Next, we're going to talk a little bit about the Graph API. Again, the goal here was to be able to reduce some of the risk, right, with this process that can be error prone. And the goals again were we wanted to come up with ways to automate these pieces that are pretty repetitive, right? We also wanted to help make the process more predictable. We hear from customers that volumes have gone up actually recently, where although they're financially impacted, the amount of discovery work has increased. And so trying to scale and keep up with this increase can be really difficult. And if there are opportunities for you to automate any of those pieces, you know, that'll allow you to do much more with a, you know, smaller staff. And then also we wanted to allow you to run these workflows that you're already familiar with. If there is a certain combination of tools that feels right, if there's a process that you've used for some time, these APIs will allow you to do that. You'll be able to apply these workflows or these tools that you've used before, but they'll leverage advanced eDiscovery. And we'll talk a little bit more about what that means. So we laid out the entire EDRM process here, right? This is all of the steps that you take to be able to run through eDiscovery. And the point here that we want to make is all of these components, there will be an API available for these. And the goal is not so much to be able to automate the entire thing, although we do have customers that are looking into that and exploring that. The goal is more like every customer might have a piece of this flow that is pretty common, pretty repetitive. And with the API, you'll be able to take any one of these pieces and automate those so that you don't have to make everything manual. Now, the other aspect of the API that's really interesting is also if you have, let's say, third-party tools that can help automate some of this process, we can help you do that with these APIs, right? So let's say that, for example, you have a legal management software or a legal intake software, and this is the application where all of the discovery requests come into. We could do things like connect the intake software to Advanced eDiscovery so that as this intake process kicks off, Advanced eDiscovery will get this signal and create a new case automatically, right? Start putting sources on hold automatically. And so now imagine how you could scale significantly more because this intake process is already automated for you. And then your pool of users, your pool of eDiscovery managers can then take from this pool and start working through the process, rest of the process. Next, we're going to talk about the enhanced collection work. And again, the goal here was we really wanted to make this flow of collecting content significantly more optimized. There were lots of opportunities where we saw where we could reduce the number of steps or consolidate some steps. And we do this because when we talk to customers, a lot of them feel like it's really expensive to go back to the well. And by expensive, they mean the time that it takes or just the struggle to get to the content. And so we see a lot of customers take entire mailboxes out or entire OneDrive sites out, and they're over collecting, right? They're trying to make it so that if they get everything, then if you miss anything, it's all there. It's just like everything is self-contained already. The problem with that, though, is that as soon as you start exporting this content unnecessarily, you're also starting to pay unnecessarily for all of this content. So our point of view is we can help customers do more iterative collections, right? Smaller, more informed collections so that as you're reviewing the content and you learn that you need to get either a few more dates from a person or maybe another person's mailbox, you can do this iteratively as opposed to spending the time of collecting all of this massive content that isn't really necessary for the case. And then lastly, we also want to provide more visibility into what is happening as the data is transitioning into this case, right? Everywhere from transparency reports to show you how many documents were collected, through processing, what was the expansion number, if there are things that are attached or things inside of zip containers, we'll expand all of it and show you what happens to that count after expansion. So these reports will make it much easier for you to kind of understand what is happening to the data and visible throughout the process. And so just to kind of double click on this piece, the collections piece, we're gonna do a comparison again. And what we wanna show here is these are the steps in the current state to start collecting content, right? And one of the pieces that we saw as an opportunity was there are a lot of great aspects of this flow, but not all of them are necessary every time you collect, right? It was almost like we were taxing customers for things they may not need every time. And so the new flow makes a lot of these pieces optional, right? It makes it so that instead of going through this process with a lot of data and waiting for all of this data to go through this process, and again, calling afterwards, which is really inefficient, the new process is going to be a little more iterative, right? The future state, the flow is now significantly more streamlined. Now you add your data sources, you collect the content, you wait for that collection to complete, and you start your review, right? So let's say that that's iteration one. And as you're reading this content and you learn more about what you need, you go back and you go through this really small process to iterate and collect a little more content. And so the idea is this iterative collection phase or workflow net will be significantly faster than if you do all of the content, right? If you do all of that content, you're waiting on processing time, on data transfer time, on host time, on analysis time, on all this content that's just unnecessary. So that was kind of a highlight of the work that we were doing that kind of aligns to the goals that our customers have been sharing with us. We thought we'd also take this opportunity to talk a little bit about what we're going to be working on next. What are the things on our to-do list? And just at a high level, the themes that we have here are we want to do more around native capabilities, right? Teams is a great example. A lot of our customers are asking for deeper discovery of some of the really awesome things that the Teams team is doing. More SharePoint, you know, deeper discovery of SharePoint. decryption, right? If I'm getting content from SharePoint and it's encrypted, automatically decrypt scenarios. So we are looking for these, this feedback. We're talking to our design partners. And thank you again for those that are listening. Really appreciate the feedback. And then we're also going to be investing in performance. Some of the customers that are recently onboarded are bringing in some, you know, very complex cases. They're very large cases. And we love that. You know, from an engineering perspective, these are great challenges that we really look forward to working on. So these are just some of the themes. Stay tuned. We're excited to kind of share more as things progress. But for now, I want to kick it back to Caroline to close.
Thanks, Aram. That was really great. So Advanced eDiscovery is part of the broader set of compliance capabilities offered in Microsoft 365 to help you intelligently manage your risk and compliance for your organization. So thanks, everyone, for your time. To get started, you can access the new Advanced eDiscovery capabilities through the E5 trial or the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center. Also, learn more. You can actually learn more through the videos, through this link that we provided here, or you can actually learn more through the documentation that we provide. Again, thanks so much for your time and really hope that you can try our features and let us know what you think through our blogs or through user voice. Thanks so much again, and we hope that was valuable for you guys.